Hopefully you've done the last couple of homeworks, and therefore this video doesn't give anything away. This set of homeworks is actually important. What do we say here? Well, if we are given an arbitrary vector A, and we look at all vectors that are multiples of that vector, then that is a subspace. Now we have seen this, okay? We had seen a vector xn such that A times xn was equal to 0, and then we looked at all vectors beta times xn, and we saw that those also map to 0. And notice that what this exercise here asks is, if you're given an arbitrary vector, is it the case that the set of all multiples of that vector is a subspace? And the answer is yes. Okay, and the way you would prove that is, first of all, you know that 0 is in this set. Why? Because you can pick chi to be 0. And you know that if x and y are in the set, then you know that x is some multiple of A and y is some other multiple of A. But x plus y is equal to chi A plus psi A, which is equal to chi plus psi A. And therefore, the result of this is just a multiple of the vector A, and is also in that set. And naturally, if alpha is some scalar, then alpha times any vector that satisfies this is just a multiple of the vector A. Here's one that's a little bit more complex. What does this here say? Given two vectors A0 and A1, look at the set of all vectors that are linear combinations of those two vectors. And it turns out that that's a subspace. And you can prove this in a very similar way as the last one. I'll just let you look at the proof that came with the homework. This here is just a rewording of that. Notice that this here says the set of all vectors chi 0 times A0 plus chi 1 times A1, because this is just viewing these vectors as the columns of a matrix, multiplying times any vector of size 2 with components chi 0 and chi 1, which is exactly how this problem looks at it. It says, look, if we have a matrix A with only two columns and a vector with only two components, and we look at all possible vectors that come out of multiplying A times X, that defines a set of vectors, and it turns out that that set of vectors is also a subspace. And this then leads to the topic of the next unit, where we would discuss what the column space of a matrix is.